Spring cleaning is here, and Appalachian Wireless has the deal to get you started. Get a Samsung Galaxy S8 for a penny or a Galaxy S8 Plus for only $89.99 on the region's best network. Better service, bigger savings. That's today's Appalachian Wireless.
2-year agreement required. See store for details.
Kentucky's primary election is officially over. While there is still the general election to look forward to in November, there may be some loose ends to tie up. In Floyd County, there were three races that were too close for comfort. Come January, Floyd County will see a new county judge executive. James Jimmy Rose overcame incumbent Ben Hale. That doesn't mean it was an easy feat. Rose had 34.9% of the votes, while Hale had 34.6%. That means Rose won by 31 votes. In the magistrate's race in District 2, George Ousley won by 52 votes. And in the contest for magistrate in District 3, Mike Tackett beat Warren Jarrell by a whopping 5 votes.
I've had some races that was 2-vote difference and small vote differences, but never had 3 races to all be that close.
Waugh says this is another reason why voting matters.
A person could have more people for them and still lose. The only thing that matters and the only thing that counts is who came in to vote on that day.
Even though nothing is in writing yet, county officials are expecting there to be at least one re-canvass in Floyd County.
A re-canvass, basically all you're doing is going back and making sure there wasn't any clerical errors or anything like that.
Once there is a re-canvass, candidates may ask for a recount, which then goes through the court system. Candidates have until Tuesday at 4 o'clock to request a re-canvass. In Prestonsburg, Shelby Porter, EKB News.